Hello everyone, myself Geeta HR, Assistant Professor, Department of Mechanical Engineering, GC, Kushalnagar. In session 1, today we are going to discuss about welded joints. Here is the table of content. Firstly, we are going to discuss introduction to welded joints. Next, we are going to discuss about classification of welded joints, then fillet joints. Next, we are going to discuss about advantages of welded joints over riveted joints. Lastly, we are going to discuss about strength of butt joint. Introduction to welded joint. First, we should understand in introduction, what do you mean by welding? Welding means it is a process of joining two or more similar or dissimilar materials by the application of heat and with or without the application of pressure and a filler material is called as welding. In welding process, the heat is required for the fusion of the material. It is obtained by burning the gas or by an electric arc. And this welding is extensively used in manufacture of automobile bodies, aircraft frames, machine frames, tankers, boilers, and this welding is used in repair work, etc. Next, we are going to discuss about types of welded joints. In welded joints, it is classified into mainly five types. The first one is butt joint. Second one, lap joint. Third one, edge joint. Fourth classification is T joint. Last classification, that is corner joint. First, we will discuss about butt joint. Butt joint means in butt joint, the two metal pieces are placed in a same plane and a welding is carried out. That type of joint we call it as a butt joint. Second one is lap joint. Lap joint means in lap joint, the two metal pieces are placed one above the other and a welding is carried out. That type of joint we call it as a lap joint. The third one is edge joint. In the edge joint means it is a joint between the edges of two or more parallel components. That we call it as a edge joint. T joint means it is a joint between two metal pieces which are positioned at right angles to each other. That we call it as a T joint. The last classification is corner joint. In this, in corner joint, the two metal pieces are joined at the corner. That joint we call it as a corner joint. This is all about its classification of welded joints. In lap joints, it consists of three types of fillet welds. The first one is single transverse fillet. The second one is double transverse fillet. The third one is parallel fillet joints. In next slide, I will show the diagram of a single transverse fillet, double transverse fillet, and parallel fillet joints. This is the fillet joints. The first one is single transverse fillet. So before going to understand this, you should know what you mean by transverse fillet. Transverse fillet means if the welds are perpendicular to the direction of applied load, that we call it as a transverse fillet. First figure shows the single transverse fillet. The second figure shows the double transverse fillet. The third one is parallel fillet weld. So here we should understand what you mean by parallel fillet. Parallel fillet means if the welds are parallel to the direction of applied load, that we call it as a parallel fillet weld. Now we are going to discuss about advantages of welded joints over riveted joints. So when compared to riveted joints, welded joints are very lighter in weight because due to the elimination of straps, cover plates, and etc. Then when compared to riveted joints, welded joints are lower cost. That is the main advantage. The third one is in manufacturing of welded joints, easily we can manufacture welded joints when compared to riveted joints. That we can say ease of fabrication. The fourth advantage is when compared to riveted joints, the efficiency of the welded joints are high as 100%. The fifth advantage is welded joints are very less noisy when compared to riveted joints. Next advantage, the welded joints can be assembled easily to meet the product requirements when compared to riveted joints. The last advantage is welded assemblies are high and leak proof as when compared with riveted assemblies. This is all about advantages. And also in advantages, the production time is less when compared to welded assemblies. Whereas the last advantage is when two parts joined by riveting, the holes should be made in the parts to accommodate those rivets. This hole reduces the cross-sectional area of the members, and this will result in stress concentration. So there will be no such problem in welded connections. So this is all about advantages. Next, we are going to discuss about strength of butt joint. As you all know, what do you mean by butt? Butt joint means in butt joint, the two metal pieces will be lying in the same plane. That type of joint we call it as a butt joint. Here, figure shows the welded joint. It is subjected to tensile load. Here, the welded joint is subjected to a which type of load? Tensile load. That load will be F. F is the applied tensile force, whereas L is the length of the weld and H is the throat thickness of butt weld. Here, when the butt weld, when it is subjected to tensile load, the average tensile stress in the weld, that is a sigma is equal to, the formula is, as you all know, stress is equal to force by area. So sigma is equal to F by area is H into L. So what do you mean by H? That is throat thickness of the weld into length of the weld. In figure B, butt weld subjected to a shear force. In the figure B, you can observe the butt weld is subjected to a shear force F. Then the average shear stress in the weld, that is toe, is equal to shear stress, it is denoted by toe. Toe is equal to, again, force by area. Toe is equal to F by area, means H into L. What is that H? Throat thickness of the butt weld into length of the weld. Next, the figure C shows a double V butt joint subjected to a tensile load. Here in the figure C, double V butt joint, it is subjected to which type of load? Tensile load F. So how to calculate for the double V butt joint the tensile stress? Means the average tensile stress, that is equal to F by H1 plus H2 into L. H1 plus H2 into L. So what is that H1 and H2? H1 and H2 are the heights, throat thickness of V. So that will be H1 into H2. L is the length of the weld. So this is the strength of butt joint. Thank you.